Okay, let's start it. Everyone, good morning.
Good morning,
good morning, everyone.
Good morning, miss.
How are you?
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
Thank you. Fine.
Yeah, how was your midterm test last week? Did it go well? Was it good? Or no? Gimana midterm testnya kemarin? Semuanya baik-baik aja? Which one?
Yes, it's good, miss. I hope it's good.
Which one do you prefer, doing your test at home or at school? At home with your mobile phone or at school by using your pen to write the answer? Which one do you like better? Enakan mana? Di sekolah apa di rumah?
Home, miss, home.
At home, why? Kenapa bintang?
So, if you don't know the answer, you can look up in the internet.
Oh my God.
Yes.
You are too honest. Oh my God. Okay, but at school you couldn't do that. But is there any time for you to do that? Bintang.
Yes.
You still have time to do that, to search the answer on something?
Only like about two answers, and then
and then what?
The rest of it, I just, you know, I just...
guess the answers.
Yeah, I just guess the answers.
What? Didn't you study?
Yeah, I studied, but like some of the material, because we study at home, right?
Mm-hmm.
And some of it, I don't understand any of it.
Oh, okay, I see. Because, you didn't get the explanation from the teachers directly at the classroom, so... it is hard for the students to understand the material, all right. Yeah, I really understand that, but but still, I don't know how I should command that condition, but yeah, and then still, it's not a good thing to do. Yeah, Bintang, and also others, I believe that maybe some students do that. Still, it is not a good thing to do. I don't know. We should survive with this condition. The teachers also, they work hard to try to give the material to you as clear as possible. We are also studying. We are also adapting with this condition. It is not if you ask us whether we like it or not, we don't like it. We don't like these conditions. Of course, it will be better for us to teach you directly at the classroom rather than doing it like this, only see the screen of our devices, our laptop or our mobile phone, and then although we can see your faces there, but still the interaction doesn't seem real, right? Do you agree with me? Interaksi kita itu kan kayak cuma apa ya, menatap layar. Although we can communicate to each other through these devices, through some platforms, but still there's something like block us, seperti ada yang membatasi kita. So of course that condition makes everything that we do maybe cannot be received by the students maximally. Tetap saja walaupun how creative we are, how maximum we are in preparing, in doing everything, in teaching the material to you, of course the students need the direct guidance from the teachers. Jadi butuh bimbingan secara langsung ya dari guru for understanding everything. Yeah, like when you were studying at the classroom, when you don't know something, you can like just directly ask it to the teachers. But right now, maybe if you don't understand something, you are too lazy to ask it. Or maybe kamu merasa sungkan juga mau tanya ke guru ya. Or maybe some teachers didn't give the good response when you ask something to them, because the conditions of the teachers either are not easy to do this. mungkin mereka juga sibuk menyiapkan ini itu, so they don't give a good response to you. But whatever it is, we should survive with this condition, survive dan juga beradaptasi gitu ya. Kita lagi disuruh sabar pasti satu, and then the second is kita sedang dibimbing ke sebuah keadaan yang baru bahwa students sekarang dituntut untuk belajar secara mandiri. Even the teachers too. Guru pun juga sama. Ya, dituntut untuk belajar mandiri. Jadi tidak selalu dituntun, ayo langkahnya ke sana ya. Ayo langkahnya kamu menuju ke sana. Ayo ini yang harus kamu pelajari. But right now the students are pushed to do everything by themselves. So they are the one that are responsible with what they do. Jadi apa yang kamu lakukan, that's what you get. Okay? Itu saya sih melihat hal positifnya di situ ya. Kita sedang dibimbing untuk menjadi lebih lagi, menjadi insan yang lebih mandiri, bahwa tidak terbiasa dengan bergantung sama orang lain gitu. Jadi please survive. Okay? Jadi banyak ngomong ya. Sorry. But do you get what I mean? Yeah, so keep spirit everyone and keep motivated to do everything in the right way, okay? Okay, let's go back to our sorry. Can you go away? Let's go back to our class, and yeah, today we are inviting you to join our online class today for, I think it is mentioned clearly in the broadcast messages that we sent to the students. We are going to discuss the guidelines of the second project in LB. And what is the material for the second project? What is it about?
Asking and giving direction.
Right, asking and giving direction. So you are asked to do acts and also give directions. Okay. Can you, what is direction anyway? Direction itu apa? Kalau in Indonesian, how do you translate it? Apa direction itu?
Arah.
Arah, right. Arah. Have you got the material from MISUM in the theoretical class? Sudah dapat materinya belum?
Yes.
Sudah. Can you give me some examples of it? Contohnya kayak gimana kalau giving direction itu?
Go straight, turn left.
Uh-huh. Right, Sadrina, Nur Sadrina. Go straight, turn left, turn right, and then if you find, biasanya apa yang ditemui? If you find blah blah blah, apa tuh blah blah blahnya?
If you find T junction.
T junction, right, Fatia, thank you. T junction itu apa? Bentuknya T berarti?
Pertigaan
or crossroad, ya, yeah. Crossroad itu perempatan, something like that. And then if you find a building, a big building, contohnya kayak gitu ya. Okay, I think it's easy for you to do that, but there are something that you need to focus more in doing this project. So this is why we are holding this meeting, for explaining to you and for answering your questions, if you feel, if you think that the guidelines that we give to you is not clear to understand. Okay. But before that, let's talk about our first project, your first project, not our. Project pertama tentang asking and giving suggestions. So, before we move to discuss the guidelines, kita pengen mengevaluasi atau apa ya istilahnya. We give you the link to see the feedback from us to your presentations. Have you checked it? Sudah dicek? Sudah?
Yes,
gimana kamu komen dari kitanya? Menerima atau tidak?
Menerima, Miss.
Menerima. Komen dari kita justru terlalu baik atau terlalu jahat?
Sedang aja sih.
Oh, sedang. Pas-pasan ya, raja ya. What do you think? Do you feel satisfied with that? Do you feel satisfied with your result, with your video? Sudah cukup nggak menurut kamu? No? Kenapa, Nur Sadrina? Why do you think that you don't feel satisfied with that?
Because the feedback that I get is not so good.
It's not so good. But do you think it is the same like the presentation you did?
after I saw it again, yes.
Oh yes, the feedback is the same like the result, like the video. Okay, then. Nah, gitu ya. Sometimes when we do something, we think that we do our best, and usually we cannot see our lacking points. Kita nggak ngerti kita kurangnya di mana sih. So it is why we need other people to see our performance to evaluate us. Nah, di sini fungsi dari kita, the teachers, not only to score your presentations, but also we evaluated. Kita lihat baiknya di mana, positifnya, what is the good things from you yang harus kamu pertahankan, and then we also mention the minus points of you, minusnya di mana, so that thing that you need to fix or to improve for the next project or for the next chance if you have this the same activity. Maybe Ms. Sumarsi or Ms. Yoni can give some evaluations or just to summarize the feedback from us or to mention the things that the students need to remember or to apa ya to do biar gak diulang lagi for the next meeting. Ms. Sumarsi or Ms. Yoni, are you there, Miss?
Hey, Miss.
Okay, Ms. Sumarsi, would you like? Yeah. Sorry, would you like to help me to summarize or to mention the summary of the feedbacks from us to the students in their first project?
Okay, good. Okay, thank you. Okay, good morning all.
Good morning, Ms. Sumarsi.
Good morning.
Okay, good. Yes, about, yeah, okay, about feedback from the
Miss Marcy, hello Miss Marcy.
Okay, I think is it okay. You have okay done very good. Yeah. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Your voice is a little bit gone. Hello, Miss. Miss Marcy, now it's clear. You can continue.
Sorry, sorry. Okay. Yeah. Sorry. Okay. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Yes, Miss Marcy, you may continue.
Hello.
Hello. You may continue, Miss.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Okay. Good. Yes. Okay. Okay. About the feedback from me. Yeah. Okay. I think you remembers about the verse. Okay. How to memorize the lines. Okay. The first, use the simple sentence, not complicated sentence, yeah, okay? And also, don't make long sentence by using comma, 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 and it is very confused to remember it, yeah, okay? And second, okay, when you see, for example, when you talks about suggestion, yeah, okay, suggestion, okay? Banyak yang bilang suggestion, suggest, yeah, remember it, yeah, okay, I suggest, I give a suggestion, yeah, okay, remember it, and then also describing thing, describing a picture, don't a lot of to describe in the first project, yeah, okay, and then some student mention the lacking point, a good point also, and some students give a suggestion. I think said okay, good, yeah, okay, good suggestions. Maybe check the suggestion. Okay, this is a relationship with the topic or not. Okay, and then next is about very useful for you to have your presentation. Why? Because if you forgot the line, okay, and then you see and then you saw and then you point the picture, okay, I think is it very easy, yeah, very easy to explain it, to remember the next line, yeah, okay, and then about the video, okay, maybe it's not a focus with your camera, yeah, okay. So some student like reading the text. So maybe the next project, okay, try to remember it, yeah, okay, jangan diulangi lagi, okay. And then, for the, what is it, yes, some students explain is was too fast, jangan cepat, jangan buru-buru, yeah, okay, remember it, yeah, okay. But remember, the time is 5 minutes, yeah, okay, remember it, yeah, okay. And then, okay, the text, is it okay, yeah, okay, some student have some weak, okay, too weak the text, is it okay, yeah, okay, but maybe remember the, from the guideline, yeah, okay, dilihat lagi guideline-nya how to make a paper. And also, I think the video, is it, yeah, some student, is it okay, okay, but it is difficult to, what is it, to make a communication with teacher and between teacher and student, yeah, maybe for this project, okay, I think you have read the, what is it, the guideline, yeah, okay, not making a video on YouTube, no, but we want to look your performance by WhatsApp video, maybe, yeah, okay, we want to call you, okay. Yeah, okay, I think it is difference, and then there is no feedback, okay, yeah, okay, you didn't know about the, what is it, the mistake, okay, we didn't give the a comment directly with your performance, yeah, okay, maybe for next project, we want to change this, what is it, no, video, yeah, okay, we want to see directly, okay. Yes, so remember how to pronounce, okay, remember it, yeah, okay, yang paling banyak suggestion, suggest, ya itu salah ya, okay, not suggest tapi suggest, okay, suggestion, not suggestion, ya, paling banyak itu disalahnya di situ, ya, okay, remember it, ya, okay. And next, but, what is it? Yeah, is it okay? I think for the first project, yeah, okay. But remember, take the good point from the teacher's comments, yeah, okay. Diambil positifnya, kemudian yang kurang bagus ditinggalkan, yang itu, yeah, okay. Okay, Miss, I think that's all.
That's enough, Miss Sumarsi. Thank you.
Yes, okay.
Okay, let me add a little. Have you prepared your book and also your pen? Sudah ada note-nya untuk mencatat dan bolpen? Dicatat yang penting-penting ya ketika kita ngomong, jadi biar nggak cepat lupa. Kan kadang kita tuh terlalu pede ketika mendengar dari seseorang tuh, ah nanti juga ingat gitu. Padahal manusia tempatnya lupa katanya ya. So, to help you remembering everything, write it in your book. Itu tadi komen dari Miss Sumarsi about your first presentation, but let me add things that you need to fix. The first is kita bahas tentang structure presentasi kalian dulu ya. Ketika when you want to start the presentation, the first thing that you need to do is greeting. Jadi kamu greeting dulu, greeting. Maupun kamu bentuk video or you do it directly when you later with the new method in our second project, tetap you have to do a greeting. What greeting? If you're Muslim, you may say Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Mau Muslim pun masih juga boleh pakai good morning, just pretend on the, depends on the time. And or maybe you may use hello. But remember, don't use informal words, informal expression. Contohnya kata apa? Guys. Guys itu kita tidak izinkan untuk dipakai. Ya. So, you may say hello, but don't say it hello guys. Tapi guys-nya diganti dengan apa?
Everyone.
Everyone, right. Okay, and then some students still use the subject we. Today we want to do a presentation. Padahal di project pertama kemarin presentasinya dilakukan sendiri apa ada temannya? Or you do it in group or pairs?
Sendiri.
You did it alone, right? So if you do it alone, don't use the subject we. Ya, saya tahu di contoh yang kita kasih we give you a note how to do a good presentation. One of the examples if using the subject we, itu kalau presentasinya you do it in with pair, okay, in a pair, okay, or with groups. Tapi kalau sendiri berarti use I want to present, okay. Itu yang kedua. Pertama greeting, yang kedua use the use of subject, and the third is how to pronounce the word present. Present. Saya punya tiga kata yang hampir sama, present, present, sama present. Biasanya sering kelilingnya adalah present.
Present.
Present. Present is not you deliver something, bukan kamu mempresentasikan, tapi kalau present itu artinya apa? Present if you have a birthday, then your friends, apa?
Hadir.
Hadir, ya. Ya, hadiah. Hadiah bisa atau hadir, right. Present bisa berarti hadir atau hadiah, right. Tapi kalau mempresentasikan, you pronounce it present. Bisa diulang semuanya, present, can you say it?
Present.
Yes, good. Good. Good, that's how you say it, okay, present. Beda kalau kamu membuat ini katanya dalam bentuk noun. Kalau noun kan jadi presentasi ya. And in English, you call it presentation. Memang beda, I present, presentation. I present, today I want to present something. Today, I want to do a presentation. Ya, bedanya di situ ya. Okay, remember that. Itu yang ketiga. Next is pemakaian kalimat formal, informal. Selain guy, sometimes some students will use gonna, wanna. Itu kita tidak izinkan juga. Oh yeah, and then in the end, when you say goodbye, just say it, have a nice day. And yeah, next, I also found the students say sorry in the end of their presentation. No need to say sorry, apapun itu bagaimanapun presentasi kamu, no need to say sorry. Gak usah saying sorry for the mistakes that you made. Okay, gak perlu ya. I'm sorry if I make a mistake atau I'm sorry in my imperfect presentation. No need. You don't need to mention that in your presentation. Itu mungkin nanti sambil jalan kita tambah. Or Miss Yuni, you want to add? Or enough?
Yes, Miss Tia. I think for the review about the previous project has already been mentioned by Miss and also you, Miss.
Well, let's move on to the second, to the guidelines then.
Okay, so I believe that everybody in this meeting has already read the guidelines from us. Thank you. Have you read it, by the way, anyone? Have you read the guidelines in the classroom?
Yes, me.
Okay. So, silence is yes. Okay, I'm not going to say that you do not have the chance to read it. Can you tell me the differences between the first project and the second project? Can you mention one, two, three, four?
Can anybody mention one difference of the second project to the first project?
Because you said that you have already read it, so can you tell me one difference between the first guideline and the second guideline?
We borrow from 11.6.
Where can you point?
Wibowo from 11.6. Hello. Hello, Wibowo. Are you there? Can you speak? Yeah.
Yeah.
Can you find? Have you read the guidelines of the second project? Guidelinesnya udah dibaca lagi belum?
Belum ya.
Oh my God. Why?
Do you understand? wait. If we speak in English all the way, can you understand us by the way we go?
Hello? Yeah.
Can you understand us, by the way?
Udah, Miss.
Sorry?
Enggak, ya?
Enggak.
Kalau kita ngomongin Inggris, kamu tinggal, Wibowo.
Almis nggak kedengeran.
When we are speaking in English, okay, when we are speaking in English, do you understand what we are saying? Kamu paham nggak dengan yang kita omongin?
Nggak paham banget.
But, oh, tapi poinnya masih dapat lah ya.
Iya. Yeah.
Oke. Okay. Dan guidelines-nya benar belum dibaca lagi?
Belum nih.
Kenapa?
Belum lihat lagi.
Kenapa belum lihat lagi? Tapi sudah pernah dibaca belum?
Sudah kayaknya dah.
Oh my god.
Okay, Miss Mel, let's just leave him. Can somebody help Wibowo to explain or to mention one?
Putri from 11-6. Hello, Putri.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, can you
help? Please help Wibowo to mention the rules.
Number one.
It's okay. It's all up to you. Can be number anything.
The guidelines of asking and giving direction number one is every student will perform individually in presenting about asking and giving direction.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Next, do you know
the
next topic?
Nah, poin kedua.
Poin kedua. Topic will be about giving direction from your house to nearby place of your house.
Nearby.
Point three is submit the topic to a provided. Yes?
It's nearby, not nearby.
What? Terus?
Nearby. Pronounce it nearby. Places.
Nearby.
Yeah, can you repeat place that point? Yeah, repeat that point, please.
The topic will be about giving direction from your house to a nearby place of your house.
Okay, thank you, Putri, for mentioning the two numbers of the rule. Now, let's get back to Wibowo. Hello, can you hear me? Wibowo, can you unmute your microphone, please? Okay, Wibowo, apa rules-nya, Wibowo?
Macet-macet nih.
Okay.
Apa?
Okay. Tadi yang dibaca
okay, your
sama...
job, your next job is to read, to study the guidelines, Wibowo, ya? Yeah?
Oh, iya. Yeah.
Okay? Because we don't want you to be confused what to do. Okay? You don't have much time to do your second project. It goes for everybody, okay? You don't have much time to prepare anything. You only have 1 week to prepare your script. Okay, starting from today, you are going to submit, today is going to be the day for you to submit the topic to us. Okay, and then after that, you will only have 1 week to create your text. Okay, it is going to be a little bit the same like what you have done before. Yeah, the standard format and anything, it will be the same. All you need to do is to read the guidelines, okay? Read again, and if you have questions, you may chat us. Do you understand anyone?
Yang terakhir itu macet-macet nih.
Iya, iya, okay. Yang lain ngerti nggak?
Coba Wibowo, tell what you hear. Yang kamu tangkap dari tadi yang dibacain Putri, ada nggak?
Oh, itu baca yang nomor satu ya, Miss?
Coba, nggak usah dibaca, yeah. Yang kamu pahami apa? Presentasinya tentang? Tentang apa, Wibowo? Tadi kamu, Putri baca, kamu mendengar, yang kamu dengar apa?
Ini apa, tiap murid perform sendiri.
Tentang apa? Yang diperformkan tentang apa?
Guideline asking giving direction.
Ya, tentang asking giving direction. Terus?
Terus?
Topiknya yang seperti apa?
Apa, Miss?
Topiknya harus seperti apa?
Rumah-rumah.
Oke, thank you.
Karena banyak macet
nih. Iya, oke, ya udah ya. Makasih ya.
Oke, okay, thank you Wibowo. Please, okay. I think we have, yeah, maybe not only Wibowo have trouble with the internet connection. Sometimes I do that too. The differences between the first and the second project is that we are going to interact directly. Okay, you are going to perform directly in front of us because you are going to do that to the WhatsApp video call. Okay, you are going to deliver your material to a video call by WhatsApp. Okay, so it will be much better for you to find a good position for you to have the internet connection before you do your presentation. Okay, so besides the guidelines, we have already post the schedule for every one of you to have the time for having the video call from us. Okay, there will be only 7 to 8 students for each week. Okay, and while the other students are going to have the activity with Ms. Marcy in the theoretical English classroom. Okay, jadi ada 7-8 orang yang presentasi directly in front of us, okay, with us to WhatsApp video call, dan yang lainnya mungkin akan mengerjakan quiz, tugas apapun itu dari Ms. Marcy. Okay, do you understand that? Can you give your thumbs?
Yes,
okay, good. And the other thing that is different is about the properties that you are going to use. Okay, in the second and the first project, we were asking you to print the picture, right? But this time, we are not going to ask you that again because we are allowing you to use the pictures from your gadget, from your cellular phone, or from your laptop, or from your tablet, or maybe if you want to print it out, it's okay. Okay, so you may use any kind of properties. Okay, but you have to remember the maximum pictures that you are going to use is only 3. Okay, we don't want you to only show and mention the name of the place, okay, because the topic for the second project is to give a direction from one place to another place, which is from your house to a destination that you like. Okay, it can be any places, ya, destinasinya boleh apa saja, boleh tempat warung yang sering kamu kunjungi, boleh tempat yang sering kamu kunjungi, misalkan rumah teman kamu, atau misalkan masjid yang sering kamu datangi. But it should be a place that is really near from your house. Okay, because we are expecting you to stay at home all the time. Okay, so do not make an excuse for your parents to go outside too far from your house just to take the picture of the destination, for example, for doing this second project of LD. Okay, we are expecting you to stay around your house to take the pictures. yeah. And the maximum pictures is only 3. Hanya 3, tidak boleh lebih itu. Okay. 1 boleh, 2 boleh, 3 boleh, 4 boleh. Do you understand that? Okay, the last one is about the I was a bit disappointed with the result of your first project, but I think it is still okay because it is the very first time for you to have the classes in LD, right? And our activity mostly is about speaking. Okay, we are training you to be able to speak directly. But unfortunately, when we gave you the assignment for having a presentation using a video, by recording it in a video, we are still saw you not really expressing your ideas, okay? Showing the picture and also expressing directly in front of us. Because sometimes it seems like you are, like Mr. Marcy said, at the review, okay? Some of you still seem to be reading because you're not facing to the camera. You're facing to the other side, to the right or to the left side. And we are assuming you that you are reading at that moment. Okay, whether it is correct or not, I'm not going to say it is yes or no, but it becomes an evaluation for us to change the method. Okay, we are changing the method to the second project by doing your presentation through the WhatsApp video call, because we can interact with each other, right? We can correct your pronunciation, we can correct when you use the informal sentence, like the formal terms, like this we said, the gonna. Once you say that, we are going to correct it for you. Do you understand that? Yes or no? Please respond me.
Yes, miss.
Okay. So we are going to correct you directly, okay? Even though your time is only 5 minutes for presenting, okay, remember your time to present is 5 minutes only, okay? And we are expecting you to put details on describing the picture, okay? Yes, the topic is about giving direction, asking because you're not asking a direction from somebody else, right, in this moment, because you are doing it monologue, because you are doing it alone by yourself, okay? So you're not asking a direction from somebody else. But we are adding some other aspect in your presentation by describing your place, your places. Can be your place or your places, the places that you passed by.
Hello, Miss Yoni. Miss Yoni, are you there? I think there's a problem with Miss Yoni's connection. Hello, everyone. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, Miss.
Yes, Miss.
Okay, let me continue.
Yes, Miss.
Hello, I'm back.
Hello, okay, Miss. Please continue. What's wrong?
Yeah, what was wrong? Who was I?
Please continue.
Okay, sampai mana tadi Miss Bia?
Formal and informal words.
Yes. Okay. So what you need to do is to use the formal and informal. Use the formal words, not the informal ones. And once you say that, we are going to correct it for you. Yeah. It's going to be more interactive. It's going to be more communicative between you and I. So, you know. Okay. And the other aspect that we want from you is to describe to the places that you passed by. Okay. Pilih 3 tempat maksimal atau 1 tempat saja atau 2 tempat yang menurut kamu mudah untuk dideskripsikan. Remember, you have to describe the picture, not the place. Ya. Kalau misalkan kamu pilih tentang a coffee shop or maybe a big restaurant as the destination, and then you want to describe the place, the restaurant, you might have the content of your description from another source. But that is not what we want from you. Kita nggak mau seperti itu. Atau misalkan kamu pilih dari rumah saya ke mall, kemudian kamu deskripsikan tentang mall. Kemudian tandanya bukan yang ada di gambar, tidak seperti itu. Okay? We want you to describe the places that really can be seen from the picture that we put. Do you understand? Do you understand that?
Yes, miss.
Mm-hmm. Very good. And yeah, the last one is because we are going to have a video call. It's not going to be, yeah, maybe it's not going to be easy for someone who feel nervous easily. But I believe we believe that you can, you can do it. Okay, you can do everything out. Okay. What you have to do is to prepare, okay, prepare it well. Yes, of course, you can memorize the lines that you have already put in your script, in your text. But since you are going to do it directly, maybe it's going to be not the same, okay, everything that you are going to say with the things that you have already written in your text, okay? So you may improvise, okay? You may use your own words, use your own different ideas when you are presenting it in front of us, okay? Maybe once you forget, take a look the picture that you hold. Kira-kira apa lagi yang saya mau sampaikan, ya? Jadi tidak hanya mengingat, going to be different. You are going to speak it, you are going to express it directly in English. And it's going to be more interesting for me personally, okay? Because when I saw the videos, I just could look at today my laptop, yeah? And I could not, give my feedback directly to you, but this time, if the time is still enough, we are going to give you some feedback at the end of your presentation. Okay. And remember, there will be 2 sessions. The presentations for 5 minutes, and another session is about the question answer session. We are going to ask you some questions related to your presentation or related to your presentation. But don't worry, it's going to be easy. Questions will be very easy because we are not going to ask you a question without seeing the pictures or without hearing, without listening to your presentation. Pasti pertanyaannya akan nyambung dengan apa yang kamu sampaikan, apa yang kamu tunjukkan di gambar. Okay? Okay? Ada yang sudah punya ide mau bikin topik apa? Kasih topik apa dari rumah kemana?
Hello.
Did I miss something?
No, I think. Just let's open the question and from the students if they need more explanation.
Questions? Please, anyone?
Questions? Is it not? Okay, after you got the explanation from Ms. Yoni, although maybe it doesn't explain or discuss all the points in the guidelines that we give to you, but it has discussed the main point of the guidelines. Now we are opening the question session from you. So please ask us if you want to get more explanation. And what is it about? Just ask it to us. Hello?
Okay, you may also write the questions to the chat. Chat room, it's available for you to give your questions. If you're too shy to speak, you may write it down now. Please.
Atau semuanya sudah jelas? Is everything clear?
Yes. I want to ask.
Yes, Fatia, please.
I want to ask Miss Fatia. I want to ask. Get used to it.
I want to ask.
Get used to use that, okay?
Yes, okay. I'm sorry, Miss. Carry on. Can we choose the topic direction to the other our room? Still in the home.
You may. For example, like from your
living room to the kitchen, or yes, living room to the bathroom.
Yes, yes, you may. You may choose that topic from your bedroom to the kitchen, or from your kitchen to your garden, something like that, right? Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, you may use that topic as long as you can show direction on it. Yeah, and I think it is a good decision for choosing that topic because it will be easier for you to explain everything because you are familiar with it, right? And yeah, it is easy for you to take a picture of it, right? Is that enough?
Yeah, enough. Thank you.
You're welcome. Any other questions?
That is a question mostly of Tom Karen.
Please,
maaf, saya. Karen, can you write it in English, please? Okay, for now. Ini cuma saya ingin bertanya apakah gambar kata yang di tulisannya boleh digambar dengan tangan.
Hello, Karen.
Karen. Yes, it is. Not it may, but it is. You have to create the map by yourself. You have to make a handmade map. Okay? Just make it easy for you. Make it simple for you to get just like Miss Ria did. Have you watched Miss Ria's video? Anyway? Have you watched
video,
Miss Ria's
video? Video contohnya sudah ditonton, Karen?
Baru setengah.
Tapi ada mapnya nggak di situ? Lihat mapnya Miss Ria nggak?
Ada.
Iya. Keren banget nggak? Enggak ya, biasa aja kan? Okay, no, so you don't need to think complicated.
You make me feel bad,
okay? It's very simple, okay? But yeah, we are not expecting you to draw a very complicated map. Like, pretend that you are Dora the Explorer, you know, Dora. A cool movie that you watched when you were kid.
Tahu Dora?
Yang punya?
Dora the Explorer tahu nggak?
Tahu nih.
Tahu ya.
So you are going to pretend like Dora, okay? You'll be Dora this time. You are going to create a map.
Karen the Explorer.
Yes. Okay, so make it simple for you, okay? Make everything simple for you. Do not put too much burden in doing this second project, okay? Okay, Karen, is that answering your question?
Thank you, Miss.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. Let's move on to Ratu. Hello, Ratu.
Yes, miss.
Yeah, can you read your questions to us?
Is there any limit for the distance of the topic we choose?
The answer is no, but we really suggest you to only choose a nearby place. Jadi tempat yang dekat aja, because first you only have 5 minutes. 5 menit gak terlalu panjang. When I made the video example to you, for you, it is hard for me to explain everything in detail. 5 menit gak panjang ya. Jadi yang sederhana aja petanya, tidak perlu muter-muter harus naik angkot dulu or something like that. Okay, just use the simple map and then simple direction too. So it is why we suggest you to choose the nearby place. Okay. But actually, there is no limit for the distance, not at all. But we suggest you to use the nearby place. Okay, Ratu.
Okay, thanks, Miss.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Can I add, Miss Pia?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, I still saw some students from another classes who have already submitted the topic. Some of them. Choose the page which is not too close to that house. Okay, they choose like a coffee shop or like a big restaurant that is familiar among us. And I'm afraid that if you choose a place like that, you wouldn't be. We'll tend to get the content from another sources like I mentioned before. Yeah, that really describe the picture that you have. Ketika kamu memilih tempat yang terkenal, tempat yang ada di luar sana, yang populer gitu, kamu akan dapat kontennya dari internet. Okay, we are afraid that you get the content not from your own. Okay, because we don't want you to do that again. So if you did that in the first project, karena kalian kita berikan kesempatan to choose the topic for the first project, ya. Yeah. Misalkan taman mini, kebun raya dan lain sebagainya. Hal-hal seperti itu kan kita bisa ambil kontennya dari sumber. So we are afraid that if you choose this kind of places, it would not be original from you again. Okay. Tapi boleh saja sih kalau emang kamu suka sama tempatnya ya, you may choose it. But remember, focus on describing the picture. Okay. If you happen to pick a restaurant, for example, or coffee shop, do not talk about the prices. Harganya murah nih, makanannya enak enggak, kita juga tahu apa enggak gitu ya enak banget. It's only your opinion, ya murah buat kamu belum tentu murah buat saya, enak buat kamu belum tentu enak buat semua orang, ya kan? Okay, so please try to pick a place that is really simple to describe and really accessible for you from your house. Okay.
Ratu.
Ratu.
Ya, Ratu
and everyone. Okay, Miss. It's there for me. Thank you.
Next question from Rahmawati. Hello, Rahmawati.
Yeah, Miss.
Can you say your question directly?
Pakai bahasa Indonesia gak apa-apa, Miss.
Nah, okay. English.
Coba dicobain English.
What is the point? Just mention the point.
Point aesthetic, right? Yeah. Point aesthetic.
Apa intinya?
Titik awal buat petanya itu harus dari rumah kita atau
Starting point.
Oh iya. For the starting point. Short form
our house
or not.
Miss your eyes.
It is. Because the topic is from your house to another place, okay? But like the question from Fatia, you may choose a specific room in your house to the other room, still in your house. Kalau seperti itu, boleh. Misalkan dari kamar kamu ke garasi, dari kamar kamu ke toilet, okay? It will be different, okay? But if you choose another place which is not in your house, you have to put the stopping point in your house. Okay, the stopping point should be your house to another place. Saya Rahmawati, bisa ada sering yang question?
Maaf, Miss, gak kedengeran.
Ya, intinya adalah if you choose a place which is not in your house, the destination, the stopping point should be your house. Can you hear me?
Stopping point-nya harus your house, Rahma.
Start.
Nah, dan ke tempat yang dekat. Jenny, can you may continue?
Yeah. But if you want to choose the rooms, the direction from one room to another room in your house, itu kan beda kasus. Jadi dari kamar kamu, misalkan mau ke front yard atau mau ke backyard, okay? So you may change it. But if you choose a destination which is not inside your house, your starting point should be in your house. From my house to Makbo, misalnya. Kalau
rumahnya Cihelep ya?
Ya, misalkan rumahnya Cihelep. Okay. Okay. Is clear enough?
Rahma?
Yes,
belum?
Miss. Thank you.
Oh, okay. You're
right. Another question from Praja. Hello, Praja.
Yes, Miss.
Can you mention your question directly? Coba dibaca dulu.
May you give an example about what question that the teacher is going to ask to us when the presentation
during the presentation. I think Ms. Yanil Nisum can answer it.
Okay, Raja, have you got an idea to be your topic, by the way?
Yes, Miss.
Mm-hmm. What's that? Can you mention from your house?
Sorry, Miss, I can't hear you.
Can you mention your topic?
Oh, I'm going to give a direction to Mas.
From?
Oh, from my house to Mas.
To, okay, if you happen to choose a Mas, you have to mention the name, okay? Kan masjid banyak ya, so you have to mention, you have to type the name of the mosque, okay? And what kind of pictures would you like to show to me? For example, if I am
kira-kira gambarnya apa, Praja?
Gambarnya, kalau kamu dikasih kesempatan 3 gambar atau hanya 2 gambar, gambar apa yang akan kamu tunjukkan?
Pertama, gambar rumah saya.
Okay. Dari mana posisinya? Dari mana? Rumah kamu dari mana?
Dari depan ya, dari depan rumah. Terus ke masjidnya sama pertigaan.
Okay. Pertigaan dan masjid. Jadi yang seperti itu ya. So I'm going to ask you about anything in your house. Kalau misalkan kamu ambilnya dari depan, it should be, I believe I can see the front door, the windows, right, the roof, and anything. So you are going to, you will describe it, okay? In your presentation, you are going to describe your house, yeah? I believe there are so many objects there, okay? So if you miss one object or two objects when you are describing your house, I'm going to ask you. Okay? Do you know how to describe, Kajak? Do you know how to describe?
Yes, Miss.
Coba, kira-kira apa? Kamu tahu, ingat kan rumah kamu seperti apa?
The colors of my house are red and black.
Yes. Okay, and then you move on to the, kemudian yang lebih spesifiknya, misalkan.
Ada apa aja yang nampak dari depan?
There is also a garden, small garden, and also a car.
Parking. Parking in the garage. Seperti itu ya?
Yeah. Nah, pertanyaannya, okay. Maybe whose car is it?
Okay, pertanyaannya mungkin ya, it's going to be a possible question for me. I'm going to ask what kind of plants are there in the garden.
Yeah, garden.
Or how is the condition of the painting? Because you're mentioning the colors of your house, the red and
black.
Yeah. Yeah, the black and red. Maybe I'm going to ask the condition of the painting on the wall. Apakah itu masih bagus, dicat baru, atau udah lama, atau udah ada banyak coretan? Okay. Have you a picture? Do you get picture of it? How to do your presentation?
Okay. Ada gambarnya nggak, Raja, nanti?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it's going to be easy, okay? We're not going to give you hard question. We will listen to you, like I said. I'm going to listen to you, and I'm going to see your pictures. Whenever you miss something in describing, I will ask you to wait. Okay?
Is that enough, Raja?
Yes, miss. It's clear. Thank you.
Welcome. The point is, in 5 minutes, it is really impossible for you to describe everything in detail. So maybe you will miss something. That's what we will ask to you in your presentation. That's the point. We are not going to ask anything that doesn't have any relation to your topic, of course not. Any other questions? No? Atau sudah cukup? Everything clear?
Can we go back to Wibowo? Wibowo, can you hear us? Wibowo, dengar nggak?
Tidur kayaknya, Miss.
Ayo, tidur ya kamu ya.
Oh,
enggak. Dengar nggak?
Dengar.
Who is your assessor, by the way? Do you know your assessor? The teacher who will assess you.
Maybe they haven't checked it, Miss.
Oh. Okay.
I just saw it a few minutes ago.
Oh. Jadi pastikan Bowo. Pastikan kamu cari tempat yang kualitas internetnya bagus ya nanti pas video call ya. Bowo.
Yeah, Bowo answering yes, Miss.
Okay. It goes for everybody, okay? If you have problem with your internet connection, tell us, okay? Let us know by chatting us, and please find another spot that is maybe more reachable for the internet connection. And when the presentation day before we do it, we will ask you to chat us first. Ya, kalau jadwal kalian berarti Miss Fia di sini mereka jam 10, jam 9.20 ya?
9.20, 9.20.
So before 9.20, about maybe from 9 a.m. until 9.19, we will ask you to chat the assessor, the teacher, okay? Because we are not expecting, I'm not going to save all numbers from the students. It's going to be hard for me to save it in my gadget. So we will ask you to chat us. ya, dari jam 9 sampai jam 9.19 kamu chat kita, okay, untuk menentukan siapa yang akan menjadi presenter pertama. Kalau kamu pengen maju, pengen presentasi pertama, berarti kamu chatnya di jam 9.00. Oh, saya pengen terakhiran aja deh, kamu berarti chatnya di jam 9.18.19. Okay, so we will pick it based on the incoming chat. Okay, do you understand?
Jadi intinya, I'm afraid that they don't understand it. Before the class starts, jadi sebelum kelasnya mulai, tanggalnya 9.20 ya, starting from 9 o'clock, mulai jam 9, yang dapat jatah presentasi harus ngechat asesornya ya. Asesornya kan berbeda-beda tiap kelas. Okay, jadi chat ke kita, and we are going to arrange the order of the presentation. Jadi urutan presentasinya berdasarkan urutan chat kamu. Gitu. Okay. Dan kalau tidak ngechat, berarti we are not going to call you. And if you don't chat us and we don't call you, of course there will be no score for you in this project. Gak ada skor buat kamu di project ini. Oh ya, yeah. Another information, this project will be your final test score, right, Miss Yoni and Miss Su?
Yes, Miss.
LB. Ya. Jadi yes. Project yang yeah. pertama itu sebagai nilai UTS kalian, project yang sekarang second project will be your final test score. Jadi harus maksimal ya. Artinya apa? Nanti ketika ujian you will not need to do a hard thing. Jadi ketika ujian enggak perlu kayak di lab-lab kimia yang kamu harus ngapalin penetapan-penetapan itu ya. No. It's enough to do this. Gitu ya. Paham, everyone? And you can, yeah, you can check your classroom. I have posted the link to see your to submit your topic. Okay, ingat topiknya ditulis from blah 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 to blah 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 and make it specific. Kalau kamu mau nyebut Alfamart, mention where the location of Alfamart is, di jalan apa atau di kompleks apa. Yeah, mention it clearly because there are more than one Alfamart or mini market in Bogor atau di kota kamu gitu ya. And then next you have to mention your active WhatsApp number. WhatsApp number yang aktif silahkan dicatat juga dan tolong tambahkan apostrofi atau koma atas sebelum nomor kamu biar akan nolnya nggak hilang ya. I put the direction there in the sheet. You can read it. Setelah itu you will know. You will get the information of the date you will do your presentation. Akan ada juga informasi tanggal kamu presentasi. Okay? Itu tanggal kamu presentasi. And also another information is the information of your assessors or the teachers who will watch your presentation. Nanti assessornya siapa? That's the assessor that you have to call. And the assessors is not only assess you or watch your presentation, but you can ask their help. Jadi selama dalam ketika kamu presentasi, when you are preparing your presentation or you got problems in making your script, you may just contact us. Silakan hubungin kita ya, or asking help from us. Yeah, is that clear?
Yes, Miss.
Ada lagi yang mau ditanyakan? Is everything clear? Jadi kapan harus ngumpulin topiknya? Kapan topik harus dikumpulkan?
Today.
Today, okay. And then tomorrow you have to check it whether we approve your topic or not. Setelah itu, what will you do?
Make the script.
Make the script. Deadline scriptnya kapan nih, Bintang? Hello or others, deadline for submitting the script kapan?
Next week.
Next week, right? Ya. Yeah. Yes, jadi, jangan ditumpuk di belakang ya tugas. Biasanya akan terasa berat bilang tugasnya banyak karena kamu tunda-tunda. Ya. Jadi kalau ada waktu kosong langsung kerjain biar nggak numpuk. Jadi kerasanya kok guru ngasih tugasnya banyak banget sih. Karena sometimes it is your own mistake yang menumpuk-numpuk tugas gitu. Itu jadi dikumpulkan sebelum next week it doesn't matter of course. Then, setelah itu, we are going to check your script, like what we did in the first project, and we give some comments and the things that you need to fix. And after that, the next week, after next week, the next 2 weeks, you have is the deadline for you to revise your script. Jadi scriptnya direvisi. Dan setelah itu, minggu berikutnya adalah is the day for you to do the presentation. Okay, that's, is that clear? Halo, jelas ya? Halo, halo everyone?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Give response, please. Kalau nggak kasih reaction kan ada tanda jempol sama tepuk tangan ya. Jadi kalau nggak ngerespon, I think that you cannot hear my voice atau penjelasan saya nggak jelas. And oh ya, yeah, and about the script, make it in Google Docs. Jangan dibuat dalam bentuk Word, okay? In Google Docs, remember? Karena di situ you can get help for getting the suggestion feature for Google Docs to check your incorrect spelling and grammar. Okay, then it will be easier for us to check your text or your script. And then the margin, ini yang banyak salah, marginnya itu 2 cm bukan 2 inch ya. Ada yang pakai 2 inch sehingga tulisannya cuma di tengah kecil, panjang banget sampai beberapa lembar. Okay. Berapa inch 2 cm itu? Find it in Google. Find the conversion of it. Silakan di Google ketemu jawabannya. Just write 2 cm sama dengan titik-titik inch. Pasti akan langsung ketemu di teratas ya. Gitu ya. Another question? Enough? Is it enough? Ya, yeah, no one is responding. Cukup ya. Okay, silakan dibaca lagi guidelinesnya. Jangan sampai salah. If you, it is not clear for you, ask it to us. And then, okay, then this whole hopefully is clear for you. And yeah, I am recording this meeting right now, and then I will edit it a little and then upload it on Classroom. So if you want to rewatch it again, if you forget something. Yeah, it will be easier for you to get the links. Okay, everyone. So I think that's enough. It's almost 1.5 hours for us to do the online meeting. Kasihan pulsa kuota kamu ya. enough, right, Miss Yuni and also Miss Sum?
Yes, I think.
Okay. Yes, Miss.
Okay.
Just contact us whenever you have you need to discuss something to us. Okay. Remember, we are going to change the font color, okay? Jadi sering-sering dilihat ya, kalau misalnya masih merah, please contact us, please WhatsApp me, okay? Or Miss Sum, okay? But, based on the assessment.
Okay, so I think that's all, everyone. Thank you so much for joining our online meeting today. And we are waiting for you to submit your topic. And after we approve it, tomorrow, starting to make your script and submit it to us. Don't submit it late because it will postpone our works. Of course, it will delay. Our work will get delayed, of course. Thank you and see you. See you when we have to see you, of course. Bye. Bye-bye and have a nice day.
Thank you.
Bye, Miss. Thank you.
Bye, Miss. Thank you.
Bye, Miss. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss.
Yes, you're welcome.
You're welcome.